Hey guys, welcome to Nagaland series, where I explore Zuko Valley, Kohima and Dimapur. I took a flight from Bangalore to Kolkata and Kolkata to Dimapur. From Dimapur, our next stop was Zakhama. Zakhama or Kigwema is the base for Zuko Valley trek. I was welcomed into Nagaland by a big storm. Here are a few facts about Nagaland. It's a state in the northeastern region of India and its capital is Kohima. We got down in Kohima and walked through several markets of Kohima. And I was quite appalled to see the things that were being sold in markets, animals-wise. Nagaland consists of 17 major tribes along with other sub-tribes. Each tribe is distinct in character from the other in terms of customs, language and dress. Several tribes of Nagaland have different languages, but Nagamese is, I think, understood across Nagaland along with Indian English. Namaste. Namaste. We settled in our homestay, which is Dawn Homestay in Zakhama or Kigwema, and we set out for a quick walk around the neighborhood. We saw this stream and decided to follow its course. Turns out that we found these stairs, which took us up to the Kigwema village. We lazily strolled through Kigwema village and found extremely beautiful biodiversity like mushrooms and wild daisies. It's day 2 in Nagaland and we started at about 9:30 to reach the Zuko Valley base. Off-roading to the trek start point was extremely fun and adventurous. Just started our trek to the Zuko Valley with Hemlata. Hey Hemlata.
Where am I?
It's raining heavily and it's good so far. It's just been 30 seconds but it's been good. And
so what's the time right now?
This is our trail. It is raining heavily but the spirits are high, so we're just powering through. We got this stick as a trekking pole from our driver and yeah, it's raining heavily and it feels good, at least for now. Let's see what happens next. This section of steep incline was extremely difficult and I took 1.5 hours to complete this stretch. Much later, once the trek was over, I understood that I was underprepared in terms of gear. I was not wearing the right shoes and I didn't carry a spare set of clothes. Looks like the hard part is over and we are here. Where are we? Oh, so good.
Gradual climb
only. Okay. Flowers
like this.
Yeah. But I thought I'd die, Hemlata. But these views are so good.
8 kilometers you have to walk. This is not finished. Okay.
The steep climb took about 1.5 hours. Hemlata, was it 1.5 hours? 1.5 hours, and now we are doing another 8 kilometer trek. Yeah. Oh, these are all bamboo. Oh, the dwarf size bamboo. It's raining heavily, but it's good. Rain is not a bad thing. But yeah, it's too good. The weather is too good. Dwarf bamboo shrubs. So I think we're just walking amongst these for some time now. I realized I've been saying that the weather is too good because I'm a pluviophile, I am a lover of rains, so it's the best setting for me that I'm trekking among the Himalayan mountains in the rain. Okay, this is a narrow route. There's no place to walk. It's all muddy like this. That's Hemlata for you guys. Now back on this trail. Walking for about, trekking for about 2.5 hours now, and
not getting easy, but the views are extremely good, and I think it's just the views that are helping us go forward. But yeah, it's extremely beautiful. I see some trekkers there. So we've been trekking for about 4 hours now, and it is not easy at all. It's very, very difficult, but the views are still good, and we see a homestay there. I think that's where we have to rest for the day, but it is not easy. The trail is muddy, slippery, and everything difficult. I got blisters from holding the trekking pole on my hand, and yeah, so I think I've become a city dweller now since I think forever now. So these kind of things are testing my mental and physical resilience, and I'm not doing so great. As in, not like, I can't say that everything is rosy and fun. At some point it became tough. The trek did become tough, and I'm at it since 4 hours. I still have an hour to go, it looks like that. So I wouldn't say it's like super fun, but it is definitely, I think I'd say that it would increase my mental strength, physical obviously not so much, but yeah, all these treks, they're supposed to be difficult, so you kind of know what you're getting into already. So not bad really, just keeping an account of my moods through the through the trek. This is the route I think we've been, it's like this since 8-9 kilometers, and I think this is how it is going to look the rest of the trek too. The challenging part though is that I have to take the same route again tomorrow, so it's not going to be any different tomorrow. Equally challenging, and probably the same use. So yeah, that's the Zuko Valley right there. That's Zuko Valley. Look at those hills. There's a cross right there, far off, and that seems to be the place that we're going to stay tonight. Okay, it looks rewarding though. So the hike is definitely tough, but it's also rewarding, especially coming off of a difficult project at work. So it feels like this is definitely needed for me. At this stage I need to be in the nature, and can't ask for better views and better place. So yeah, loving it.
we reached the night stay and look at those views. That's Zuko Valley. And this is our stay for the night. And the rainbow appeared out of nowhere.
Hey guys, good morning. We are deep inside the Zuko Valley. It's 5:30 a.m. We've been up from about 4 a.m. this morning. Couldn't sleep all night. It was all cold and wet. But we are up and about now. And we are going through the same route today. Which means we'll be taking the 8-kilometer walk amongst the bamboo trees and then the 1.5 hours steep decline today to the bottom of the valley. So that's about it today. Yesterday it took us 5 hours just to get to the base, to the dormitory here on the top of the mountain, and I walked further out a bit towards the helipad to see the 360 degree view of Zuko Valley. So almost 7 hours we were hiking, we were trekking yesterday, and today I think it's going to be about 5 hours trek to get back to the base. That's about it. This is the trail. It's muddy, slippery. It's been raining all night and it's raining even now, so this is the state of the trail in Zuko Valley.
Near this stream of water, we found some snails living on the bamboo trees. And look how amazing these are.
Stopped here for a quick banana break. We've been trekking for about 1 hour now. And yeah, it's going to take another 4 hours, but it's as beautiful as yesterday. It only feels that it's raining much more today as compared to yesterday, but otherwise it's as pretty as yesterday.
So we finished the trek and we came down to our Kigwema homestay, took a quick shower and went back to Kohima. We reached Kohima and it was raining all day in Kohima. We decided we'll take a break, especially coming off of a 2-day trek. We wanted to take a break. It's day 4 in Nagaland. We decided to visit the Nagaland State Museum. That's a smoking pipe. And the museum depicted some funerary practices of Naga tribes. Nagas are obsessed with Mithun heads, which can be seen everywhere. It was time to leave Kohima and reach Dimapur. Take me home, take me away. Our first stop in Dimapur was to visit the ruins of Kachari, or also called as Rajbari. These are medieval monuments dating back to the 10th century when they appeared during the Kachari civilization. These ruins are a series of mushroom domed pillars and were created by Kachari kingdom, who ruled Dimapur before Ahom invasion into the territory during 13th century. Their origin and purpose are largely mysterious. The pillars are not well maintained, and some pillars still stand in all their glory, but others have crumbled down. It is believed that a game similar to chess was played with the mushroom domes. We then visited a lot of tribal stores, interacted with the local tribals, and understood about the culture and the traditions of various tribes. It seems like the Naga tribal modernization happened about 250-300 years ago when the British first arrived, and the current generation wears the traditional clothes and follow practices only during festivals. And they mentioned that with the help of government, they're trying to revive their culture and traditions.
Separate tables for everyone.